We have Mallory Tidwell. Hi, Mallory.
Hey, Mallory, we can bring you on a little earlier. Is that okay?
I'm here.
Yeah, so glad we got you on. I've been following you on Facebook. You've been doing a lot of transactions, it seems. So awesome. Good to have you. So a little bit about Mallory. Mallory is a wife, mom, and realtor in the Fort Walton Beach, Florida area. She's enjoying coastal living and real estate on the Florida Panhandle. I mean, it always looks so awesome over there. The pictures you post, especially when you take your kids to the beach and it's white sandy beaches compared to what we have here. Awesome. Thanks for joining us.
Sure. Thanks. Good to get on to say hi.
Yeah, I know we get really jealous of that because one, the nearest beach for several hundred miles looks nothing like that. Especially Galveston. And two, we've been there, so we actually know personally how nice the Destin, Orange Beach, Pensacola, it's so nice. So we did a podcast. It was about almost 9 months ago. You were just licensed and like, I think you were like 3 months in.
Yes.
And you got some really quick success. So that's why I wanted to have you back because I've seen you've done more since then, obviously. And you have fun doing it, like living life, selling houses. What has been something that you have noticed as a new agent going through this first year that's helped you get that quick success?
So I like talking with people. That kind of comes natural. Anybody, anywhere, mix with my kids, always just being cordial, saying hi, interacting, getting to know people. And that can kind of help spring into, you're not promoting yourself immediately by any stretch, because that just seems weird. But you're just being out there and you're engaging and people start to get to know you. That builds it up. As well as just marketing well on Facebook has been really good among people that I know that then or they themselves are needing some real estate help. So those two things, just being chatty. People know so they don't mind it at all. And it's fun to get to know people at the same time. So.
Yeah, and you come with sincerity. So yeah. This has been a theme, like the past several guys, it's all communication. It's all talking with people because people buy houses. Yeah. Like, even if it's a company and you're dealing with like an investors or whatever, those companies are run by people. And if you talk with them, learn their needs, but also don't, if you come across with sincerity and you generally care about it, we're just talking about life. Like, hey, did y'all go to the beach today? Like the, right. The weather was amazing.
Folks, and eventually they have a need that you can meet and it's fun to just chat with them. Or they get excited to talk about beach life and go, oh yeah, we're thinking about buying a condo or we would love to move there. Or that's facilitated a few transactions as well. And then they later on Facebook and their family sitting out on the beach that you saw. That's very gratifying.
So on Facebook, have you noticed anything in particular or any type of messaging or type of engagement that's doing? I mean, maybe it's just the random posts on the beach, or has it been like video walkthroughs, or just maybe you're talking about like this gorgeous like kitchen or view? Is there anything in particular that you've noticed really help with engagement?
I do a combination. I had several that just encouraged me to just post like cool shower. I was doing some properties in Santa Rosa that is absolutely beautiful, and did a video of a really neat shower over there, letting people kind of see the inside of places. I do live videos and do final walks or just tours, and those are cool. I mean, everyone likes to see a house. Like, even if I'm in a house, I like to see the inside of a house. It's kind of cool. So I've done those, and then always sharing, like, when I put something under contract, when it's sold, so that people can see you're active. Like, they want to know that you're busy and that you're doing this pretty frequently, where you're able to keep up and be aware of what to do and what not to do in the real estate rules and world and all. So staying active, letting people see that you really enjoy it and that you're happy to help. And, you know, it's been good. I think I did 12 in the first year. So it was, you know, it will grow and build, but I'm grateful. I'm grateful for the support and help from all of y'all, and EXP's been fabulous.
Yes.
Now, I've been excited to watch it. So you said 12 in the first year, and the last guest we have on today, you know, she posted some type of study or whatever that most agents right now who, you know, have had their license for 12 months, like they don't have their first deal, or maybe it was like 9 months or something like that. You've got 12, and that's a testament to your action. I mean, everyone can accidentally get a few just because your sphere of influence, but eventually you run out of friends, family, church, right, like group and high school friends. Eventually you have to actually do the work, and you've done that. And that's been 12.
It's good. I feel like there's so much more to attain. Like, oh my God.
Oh no, there totally is. Like next year. Well, what are you looking for next year?
Oh, double. Easily double.
Double. All right.
Yeah. But I'm double. Also, as part of my bio, I'm a mom to two very young kids. I'm the main everything. Of course, daddy is too, but you know, and that's good. But they're in preschool for the mornings and the afternoons. I'm with them. And that's where I'm funneling my love is to my babies. But really, you know, something I can involve at the same time. And my kids even go do some real estate stuff with me. So it's a bit of a family affair, but my daughter goes into kindergarten this fall. It'll free up a little.
Aww.
Full-time school is a little more a part of our lives. But
that's exciting. I know Jamie remembers like when we, when our kids were preschool, like they'd go to the flips with us. Now, if it was under construction, we had to like rein them in. But when it was like staged, like, and they would remember the neighborhoods, like, is this the flip house? Or it was really... Pre-preschool, it was like, how do they remember that? But they loved it. And so your kids are going to remember those times faintly, but they'll remember it when they're older. It's like running around with mom on, these open house tours or whatever. And do you take pictures? So we got like 30 seconds. Do you like take pictures or whatever, do any videos with them?
I will do some with them. My little boy's 3, so he isn't as involved. He's just wild. But my 5-year-old daughter, she can do what she needs to do as well. So she can a little bit more, so she might be a little more noticed in content over brother at the moment. He's usually not as involved, but
all right, yeah, let them sell some houses for you.
Marketers.
Yes. Thank you so much, Mallory. I'm just very excited about everything you've done, and look forward to seeing you progress even further and double your business next year.
Chris and Jamie, appreciate the support.
Thank you. Take care.